Hello. In this video, we'll look at Google's new generative AI model garden, and specifically the two PaLM models for text and chat. When you go to the Vertex AI Model Garden, you'll see a nice filtering interface on the side here to be able to find models that you're interested in. Plenty of these models are open source, and note that some of these categories are not mutually exclusive. For example, the open source and notebook support features are highly correlated here. In any case, we've got a nice few dozen models to explore across a variety of different tasks. Just to give you an idea of a few of the model types here, if we go into the PaLM API for text, we get to it and we have a button for the open prompt design, which allows us to directly explore the model. We'll do that in just a moment. It's the same case for the PaLM API for chat. We do, however, sometimes have links out to Colab or other external projects. So, for example, if we go to ControlNet, we'll see that we can open ControlNet in a Colab notebook and start to explore and work with it there. We'll also link out to, for example, the Hugging Face page in some other cases. For other models, like the image embeddings, we get a note that the model is in private preview and we have access to the landing page, but don't actually have access to the model itself unless we sign up for that private preview. Let's now move on to an exploration of the flagship models in the model garden, the PaLM API for text and the PaLM API for chat. So we can either view the details and go to Open Prompt Design, or from the Vertex AI menu, we can go to Language and then Create Prompt. This is for the text model as opposed to the chat model, which we'll look at in just a moment. From this interface, we can write a prompt and then submit it to get a response. We'll use the button over here to submit our prompts. Now, we have a few values here. We have the temperature, which is effectively the randomness of our answer. We have the token limit, which is not the context window, but actually how many tokens can be output in the response. We also have some parameters that are a little bit lower level, like the top K and the top P for how the model selects tokens for output. Let's go ahead and use all the defaults and submit. Now, note that if you're new to Vertex AI, you'll get this message that we need to enable the API. So we'll do that. And now we'll be able to resubmit our prompt. Note that we can have some markdown output in these responses. So for example, you see these backticks, and oftentimes you want to switch from the default view to that markdown to be able to see that formatted text. If we ask for a simple example of an Angular component, that markdown output becomes even more important, and we can nicely see what's a code block versus natural language text. For the structured approach, we can provide some context and then be able to do similar request and response inferences. For example, we might say, pretend that you're a pirate, and then answer these questions. In the example section, we can help the model understand what sort of responses we're looking for. So this is a way to improve the model for our specific context, as long as we have input and output pairs. We need both sides to be able to tell the model what we'd like. In the test section, this is where we're actually going to get responses. Let's put a prompt here, and then if we again submit with our desired configurations, we'll pretty shortly get an output that takes the context and then runs the prompt that we provided in the text box. In this case, we haven't provided any input-output pairs, but those are completely optional. In many ways, the text here is similar to the OpenAI system messages, and the input here is like the OpenAI user messages. If you like certain prompts, you can save them here. Note that the name now appears at the top, which we can edit if we need to, and we'll be able to quickly pull up this prompt later. Let's also take a quick look at the code view. If we click on this, we get Python code that allows us to run the same prompt in response. We're even given some Colab-specific code in an example curl command in case we want to hit the API directly through something like a bash script. Now, note that we're using the flagship PaLM text model here, which is a very large, high-parameter count model from Google for this particular use case. Let's continue with the flagship LLMs and check out the chat model. So back to the model garden. Here's the model of interest, the PaLM API for chat. This is in the multi-turn chat category and is similar to the text Bison model, but gives us a little bit more of an interactive and iterative format. For example, we can say, what are the three best RD BMS choices? Again, we're given examples in case we have questions and answers that we'd like to share with the model as example good inputs and outputs. And as with the chat or other text models from before, this context is optional. And whoops, let's move our question to the right field here and then provide a context. Check out the parameters on the right here, as usual before we submit, and we'll get a response that's tailored based on our context here. Unlike the text model, we can iterate on this and continue to interact, and this context will be taken into account as we continue the conversation. Now, as is always the case with LLM models, you want to use these results with a grain of salt. For example, it is true that MySQL is written in C and C++, and SQLite is written in C, but claiming that C++ is integral to Postgres is a bit of a stretch. There's a C++ interface, some C++ in embedded SQL, and some C++ in pgAdmin, but the core Postgres code is definitely C. As before, we can save options here and again view the code in case we want some Python, Colab, or curl code to use this model. Hopefully, this has been a helpful introduction to the new text and chat models in Vertex AI, and specifically those that are listed in the new model garden. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions and want to thank you for watching.